is up, YouTube? South Largemouth here. I'm gonna do some creek fishing today. I'm just gonna give y'all a little video on how to do some creek fishing. Major points when you're doing creek fishing is you want to throw either finesse or you want some small lures. I like small buzz bait, small spinners. But you're not gonna be catching any codes out of a creek. You're gonna be catching, the biggest thing I've ever caught out of a creek was a 2-pounder. But what I am going to say about creek fish is that they're a lot more aggressive. It's a really fun way to fish. I'm fishing an ultralight setup right now. I'm fishing with my little brother right here. Say hello, Liam. So we're going to be doing some fishing and catch y'all there. I hooked him again. Came off. Took my freaking Senko. I don't know what I'm going to do with this fish. My last pink Senko here. Try to get him on it. I'm gonna toss top water, a little buzz bait in a little bit. When the sun's completely down, right before it gets completely dark, that's when top water, early morning and late day is when top water's killer, people. But I'm gonna keep on trying to catch him. Some crappie peas in it. And he would slay with it, so. He said, you know what, we're going creek fishing, let's throw some crappie tubes. So we're going to see who wins. I'm throwing a wacky worm. Let's see who wins, and hopefully I win. But good luck, Liam. May the best fisherman win. People, we are currently at the spot. It is like 4:30, I think. Let's try to do some bass. Okay, I already lost one. Right here, he popped off when I flipped him. It was tiny, people, tiny. I'm gonna see if I can get another one to hit. I know this is one of the best spots you can come and try to catch perch. I mean, I catch perch left and right here. Got my Senko's robbed, so just put a little 4-inch one now, because I need a smaller Senko so we can actually take it. Oh, I just got a hit there. One, people. Oh, there we go. Nice creek bass, people. Nice creek bass. There we go. That's a nice bass, guys. Wish I would have caught him yesterday. This is a keeper. On the wacky worm. Guys, I'm letting this little fish go. I'm saying he's about a 1.5, maybe a 2. Another one, guys. About pretty much the same size. Okay, another largie. Doing the same technique, exact same lure. What's up, YouTube? South Largemouth here. Liam, my little brother, just caught his first bass of the day on a charm fishing minnow, paddle-tailed minnow. I'm telling you guys, both fish I've caught today were on a charm fishing stick bait, and he caught his fish on a charm fishing paddle tail. I'm just telling you, as soon as first cast, as soon as he switched to that charm fishing, he catches a fish. Y'all really need to check these guys out. They will be linked in the description below. They are amazing, an amazing company. The folks over there are super friendly, and they make great quality lures. But I'll get back to y'all. I just caught the second bass of the his second bass of the day. We're gonna need to set a size limit on these bass, Liam, because you keep on catching these tiny ones.
That's a skinny guy.
Let me see him.
Look at that. Look at that stomach. Super.
There's a little bassy caught. So his suckers go. Oh, you wanna throw him?
Oh, I got honors.
Look at that. We're tied, baby. Is that your PB, Liam?
Oh, yeah. This is my PB, by the way. PB.
He's kidding, guys. No, that's not his PB.
PB's.
No, we're talking about PB bass, Liam.
Oh, PB bass.
Oh, I just missed one. Okay, well, I'll get back to you. Freaking huge bass. Pretty sure I got it on video. Oh my lord, that makes me so mad. Oh, I almost landed him too. I think this is my new favorite fishing spot. There's a lot of biggins. I'm guessing it's because a lot of people don't fish here. Yep. It's been a bad day. So my little brother just missed a big channel on a little minnow. I just lost a humongo bass. That really makes me mad. We popped off. Pretty sure I got the footage. He popped off right when I was about to flip him. I should have just ran up there and tried to lip him instead of flipping him. But I mean, there's nothing I can do about it. I lost him already. It's in the past. Gotta let it go and try to catch another one like that. Okay, guys. So the trick for creek fishing is you want to find some sort of structure. All the fish I've caught, well, all the bites I've had, not that I've caught too many fish today, but all the bites I've had have been on structure. This huge one I missed was on a Christmas tree in the water. I know, I don't know why someone would dump it in the creek, dump it in the lake. You can get some awesome structure there. But there's a Christmas tree in the water. Then the first two I caught were on a little log in the water. My brother caught his on some little boulders and or rocks or whatever you want to call it. And I mean, that's pretty much it. You want to throw some finesse. I'm throwing a wacky worm, a chartreuse wacky worm. You want to find some sort of, you want to find a finesse lure, or you can even throw a small topwater or small spinner. I wish I had my rooster tails with me. I could have been catching them. I mean, I wouldn't be catching as big as the ones I caught today, but could have caught a lot more than what I have right now. So how I'm fishing this wacky worm, I'm just casting it. I'm just casting it. Let's see if I can get him again. I'm just casting it. Say that like four times. I'm just casting it parallel to the shoreline or on some structure. And I'm lifting it up, letting it fall, reeling in the slack, giving it a couple jerks like that. And right on the fall, you want to keep your line tight, because right on the fall, that's usually when they hit it. You'll either see them swimming with it, or that's a snag. You'll either see them swimming with it, or you'll feel the hit. That big one I missed, I saw him swimming with it. But the other ones, I felt the hit, because those I had my line real tight. But I'm just gonna keep on trying to make some happen here, and I'll get back to y'all. Okay, he just caught another bass.
Let's check it out.
It can't even fit the hook in his mouth.
Nope.
That one doesn't big count. Fan. Throw it back in the water. I was about to say, I don't feel like eating some habanero hot sauce tonight, so thank the Lord that was a small bass. But I'm just gonna keep on trying to capitalize on some fish here. I'm gonna be hitting another creek or another branch, a little creek coming off of Lake Houston. This is already a lake right here. So we're done for this spot. We're gonna hit the next one. The lake right here is where I launched for my tournament right there. I fished all of this, all the way down as far as it goes. This spot, it used to be great, it used to be a money spot, but I don't know what happened. It's still really good for catfish. People say it's good for crappie. Never really caught one. Caught a little white bass here once. My little brother caught a drum here. But it's time to cross the road. Number one rule of crossing the road is look both sides before you cross. Oh, that's a nice truck. That is a nice truck. Forgot my little brother over here. Guys, the funnest fishing in the world has to be ultralight setup finesse fishing for bass. That is the coolest way to fish. I mean, these little 1 to 2 pound bass feel like trophy bass when you fight them on this little ultralight setup. This is right where the creek starts, right here. And the more you go down the creek, the shallower it gets. Or up the creek, shall I say. And this is where it spills out into the bayou.
Oh, I had one. Where's the perch, so it wouldn't count.
But we're just gonna keep on trying. Y'all see that over there, that little stream? That's what I'm talking about when I say structure. That is great structure right there, people. I catch them there all the time. All the time. Liam is trying to get a big bass. He's sight fishing it. He sees it on its bed. He's trying to see if he can get it to hit his minnow. But yeah, y'all see that right there, a little stream. That is a structure I'm going to be fishing. Right past it, that's where the water gets real calm before it hits the stream. And that's where the fish like to hang out. See if I can get one of those largies right there. This is what I mean is structure. Got him. This is what I mean is structure. Oh! This is what I mean is structure right here, boys. They're boys and girls, sorry. There is a cement block right there. There's running water behind me. There's a little creek running into it right there. That's a fish. I know that's a fish. Pretty sure that's a fish. That wasn't a fish. Okay. And there's a little, y'all can't see it, but there's a plate, like for lifting, for like barbells and stuff. There's a plate right there. Because there's a school right there. And I'm guessing it's from their weight room or something. And there's fish under that plate. But I'll get back to y'all. Oh, there we go. That's a bass. There we go. Got one. 3-2, Leon. Huh. A little largey. Ooh. Let this sucker go. Oh. Quick release. Y'all saw how I got him. I got him right by that cement block, and that's what I mean is finding structure. That's the number one thing of creek fishing. It's the number one thing of fishing in general, but it's an even bigger factor when it comes into creek fishing, because you're not going to have big flats with the cruising fish. They're always going to be held up against the structure. But I'll get back to y'all if I get another update or fish or something. I hooked them again, came off, took my freaking Senko. I don't know what I'm going to do with this fish. My last pink Senko here. Let me try to get him on it. I'm going to toss top water, a little buzz bait in a little bit. When the sun's completely down, right before it gets completely dark, that's when top water, early morning and late day is when top water's killer, people. But I'm gonna keep on trying to catch him. He just caught his bass. Topwater, sort of topwater. He was bringing this on the surface right here, and he got the bass who hit it. It's a fly bowl or charm fishing, same thing, lure. I'm telling you guys, they make the best lures. All the fish we've caught today have been on their lures. For the past couple weeks, I've been slaying fish on their lures, people. Great lures. Please go check them out. I'll put their description in below. And I'll put the amount of times I said lures in this like 30 seconds. I'll put a little counter. So, yeah. I can see how many times I said lure, I guess. But we're going to keep on fishing. Challenge is not over. We're going 3-3 right now. We're going to try to see who can get the most fish today, but I'll catch you on a bit. I don't know what time it is. It is topwater time, guys. Got a buzzbait right here. Little Pond Magic buzzbait.
I missed them.
This is good for these. Anything that you think would work at a pond, it's gonna slay at the creek. So I think that these buzzbait is gonna work some magic here. Liam is throwing the Bullfly Outdoors minnow, and he's just jigging it off these rocks. I'm pretty sure he's gonna get one.
I got it. Oh, I missed him.
He just missed it. But I'll get back to y'all. Missed two bass within my first five casts with this buzzbait. I think they're on it right now. Is it a bass?
No. I think
no, I know one of them was a bass because I pulled them up.
Okay,
two freaking fish, people. Whoo! That one right there was big. And then I missed, he was a little dinker right there, but still, fish is a fish. See if I can get another one to hit. Wish I had a trailer hook for this thing. I've already missed a lot of fish on it. There he went. There was another one, guys. I want to see if you'll hit it again. That was a bad cast. What you're looking for when you want to fish for topwater is where it transitions, at least in a creek, where it transitions from deep to shallow, like really shallow, 1 to 2 feet to like, oh, this is not really deep, but this is deep for a creek, something like 4 feet or something like that. A little drop off, right? When you pass it over that drop off, you're always going to get that bass waiting in the shallows for a minnow to pop up. You're always going to get that big bass, or not always, but there's always a big bass there at least waiting for prey to pass by so they can just quickly snag it and have a quick meal. And that is great. I mean, that is a great tip in my opinion if you want to get a nice bass, nice creek bass on top water or on any lure. You can get them like that. If you're going to be fishing something that's bottom, if you're going to be fishing a bottom lure, little green sunfish. If you're going to be fishing a bottom lure, you want to, you want to do it on the drop-off. You want to cast it right on the drop-off, and you're going to have that fish waiting underneath the drop-off for some bait to come down off the shallows or something. And that is one way where you can, that's one way that you can catch a nice bass. You can, if you're gonna fish like a jerk bait, bring it right off the drop off and try to get a suspended bass. Those drop offs are key points in creek fishing. That's a bass. No, that's another sun. Oh, that's a big sunny. That's a big sunny. Got a topwater bass right here. And I got this little sunny right here. Hey, Liam. What would you say? There he goes. A little sunny on top water. Let him go. Quick release. I'm gonna see if I can get another fish. Another bass, hopefully. I don't like catching these sunnies on top water because they're wasting my time for my tournament right now. I'm currently in the lead, 4-3. Yeah, 4-3, I think that's the standings right now. But he has missed a couple, and he's on a really good spot right now, so my little brother might catch up, guys. Gotta keep on fighting for this title. First place title in the family right now. Is it a bass? Dang it! Are you snagged? Oh. Thank the Lord. That sucks. Game update. I forgot I had a frog. My little brother needs a topwater lure. I'm a good sportsman. I have a, I, have a lot of sportsmanship. That sounds right, a lot of sportsmanship. I guess so. So I lent him my frog, a Lunker Hunt popping frog, because he wants to throw some top water and see if he can work some magic. But I'm just going to keep on throwing my buzz bait. I know it works because I've had bites on it. I've caught fish on it already. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. You know what they say. The bass on the top water. Liam got another bass on top water. Which just missed one. This is the kind of times where you really hope, you really wish you had a trailer hook on so you don't miss fish like this. That makes me mad. No matter if it's a small or a big fish, it always makes me mad when I miss it. Because no matter what, it was a fish. Oh. My freaking bell just slipped. And he popped off. Oh, Lord. Yeah, that's what happens when you have a cheap reel, people. I'm gonna keep on trying. My reel feels weird. Huh. So, y'all see how there's a little, there's some rocks right here and it's really shallow. Oh, I have a fish on. I didn't know that. Y'all see how there's some rocks right here and then it gets really shallow. Ooh, I hooked him in the cheek. He probably swiped at it. Oh, this is not good. There you go. He's off. Ooh, sorry, dude. Well, how it goes from shallow to deep right here. That's where the fish are gonna be hanging out. I just spooked one coming over here because I thought I was snagged, but. Oh, that's when you wish you had a trailer hook. Guys, that was a big one. See if I can get him to slam it again. Hope I got that strike on video. But I'm gonna keep on fishing, trying to make it happen out here on some Houston creeks. Missed another one. I think this video is gonna be all about me missing fish because that's all I'm doing today. Guys, I thought those. Ooh. I think I got that strike on footage. Gotta keep on trying. Another one, guys. He hit it multiple times before I actually got him. Okay, I'm gonna flip him. There we go. Got him. Nice creek largy, guys. Nice creek largy. Sure, I got the strike on video. He really slammed it. Let's get a selfie. Okay, got the selfie. Let's let this little bugger go. 6-3 is the score right now, people. 6-3. Missed another one. This one I actually hooked him, and he popped off, right off. Yep, this is totally a video about how I miss fish. How to miss fish at a creek, 101, guys. Great video. It has a lot of helpful tips. Just caught his bass. It's 6-4. We have like 20 minutes left to fish. I got a huge knot on my line because I don't know, a crappy line, I guess. He got like a 1. Yeah.
He doesn't look like a chunk, but when you look under his stomach,
it's like a little 12-inch bass.
Yeah, keeper.
No, that's not a keeper. Keeper for Texas is 14, Leo. Oh. Yeah, that really killed me yesterday. You wanna get the bass? I didn't get it on video, but my little brother just made this interesting. We're gonna hit the fire spot for like 10, 20 minutes. This is no longer a creek, it's a bayou. But he has to catch 3 fish to beat me, 2 to tie. So if we tie, we both do it. That's kinda interesting, I guess. So I just want to let y'all know about that. And I will be getting us doing it on film, on camera. But yeah, I'm going to head to the spot.
Oh, coming back from too much candy. I had some sour candy. It burns my tongue, so this is going to...
You ready?
No.
He's got his milk here because he's a little girl, right?
Yeah, I'm a little girl, but a manly kind.
Okay, Liam. Let's see you eat it. Open your mouth. Eat it.
Liam.
Now face the camera. Mm. Oh, there's still some in there, Liam. Okay. Habanero. Swallow it.
Five minutes.
5 minutes till you get your milk? Okay. Timer starts now. Is it spicy? It smells spicy. Guys, I think he might be dying.
I need paper.
What?
Napkin.
Yeah. He needs a napkin. Oh, Liam, that is disgusting.
I don't feel good.
You don't feel good? Okay, you can get your milk now. It's not been 5 minutes, but you deserve your milk. It hasn't been... What are you doing?
What time is it?
It hasn't been 5 minutes, but you can get your milk, Liam.
I'm mad. What time is it?
Stop running around. It's only been 1 minute.
What?
Just drink your milk. And that's why you don't lose fishing challenges, guys, because stuff like this happens. Guys, it's been 5 minutes. Does that make it better?
Oh, it's back. Not enough milk.
Ah, yeah, yeah, guys. So, this is going to be a new series. It's going to be how to creek fish. I have an abundance of creeks around me, so I can get some pretty good footage. And what do you think? New series? How to creek fish?
Yeah.
Huh?
Surprise.
Oh, okay.
Next
so
challenge.
We have another challenge coming up in the future. He came up with it again.
It was you. You came up with
I came up with what it's about, but he wanted another challenge. Next challenge is a Senko challenge, okay?
You can... Whoever loses, it's a surprise.
Yeah, it's a surprise, but you need to catch a Senko, you can use whatever... You need to catch a fish on a Senko using whatever method you want. You can drop shot, wacky Texas, you can weightless Texas, you can Ned rig it, you can Nico rig it. Many, many ways to use a Senko. Liam has his little secret Senko tricks with his little 132-ounce jig heads. But we're going to see if he can catch a bass using that. That's going to be the big challenge for him. But thank y'all so much for watching. Remember, this is South Largemouth. Please like, comment, and subscribe.